The state of Louisiana's five-year ports and maritime plan. So this is dated 2009. It was actually started in 2007. And this is a letter by the Honorable Bobby Jindal. I am pleased to present the attached Maritime Advisory Task Force report for 2009 for your review and consideration. Your insightful choice of task force members comprising all aspects of the maritime industry has allowed us to provide you a clear, concise, and comprehensive set of recommendations spanning the next 5 years. These recommendations, taken as a whole, will greatly improve the future of Louisiana's maritime economy, create jobs, and improve our competitive position in the global commerce. Okay, there it is right there. What they plan on doing is going from the Gulf, Louisiana, the southeastern part of it specifically, and creating the largest port in the world. It is presently ranked at 8 or 9, and they want to be number one. Now, this would include going in to Mississippi River and the deltas and the bayous and the waterways and everything else, and dredging, widening, reconfiguring locks, making flow, channel flow, so that right now it's just basically for shallow draft barges, and they want to deepen it because they now have plans for these mega ships to be able to come in and out of the port, and they just need more room. And this will include going all the way up to Canada, which exactly coincides with the XL pipeline. Okay, so here we have their Shaw Environmental Incorporation put together this extensive scope as far as what they really need to do, what they want to do, and what they're doing. Okay? So basically, it lays out the infrastructure that's needed to make this happen. And I find it very interesting that, taking into consideration what is going on in the southeastern part of Louisiana, that this is exactly what their target area is. Okay. The initial results of the project evaluation process, including all 200 projects, are noted below. 14 of the projects, or 7%, were related to flood control, levee repairment. 65 of the projects were environmental protection and restoration, because they got to do that to make it look good. 21 of the projects, or 11%, were related to channel improvements, widening and deepening of the infrastructure, particularly at the locks, and 100 of the projects, or 50%, were commercial navigation projects primarily located at port facilities. Okay. A broad profile of the Louisiana maritime transportation system, including its physical infrastructure, operational framework, and significance for economic development, has been presented. The basic approach was first to conduct a detailed inventory of the resource base, to analyze existing conditions and constraints, and then to examine alternatives available for improving the state's waterway system. The results of that planning process are summarized below. Matters that restrain and/or minimize optimal operational efficiency and hinder maximum economic impact potential of the state's navigable waterways are targeted. Okay. So, let me see. There's so many pages here, I think I am getting lost in all the things I wanted to share. So, basically, in all of this, they're taking all of these areas and what has to be done. Deepening channels, dealing with the sediment traps. Here we have Iberia. There's also a lot of maps in here that clearly shows you what they're doing, and it goes all the way to Canada. Okay. Southeast Louisiana captures 7% of U.S. population within a 500-mile radius compared to 14% for competing ports. So they no longer want to be 8 or 9 on the list. They want to be number 1. And they have statistics for everything. Okay. They talk about what the you know, problems are, bottlenecking, just, you know, all of it. All of it is in here. And finally, here is this is what ties this little package up, is the expansion of the Panama Canal. Because in this, they are making the Panama Canal bigger so that they can allow these mega carriers to pass through the canal by 2014. And so basically, they will dominate the world shipping, new trade lanes will emerge, vessel draft, air and water is a challenge for U.S. ports. Well, they're just going to build their own down there in Louisiana so that this is what they can put together. And yes, I understand that the world is only getting bigger. It's not getting smaller as far as population needs and demands. I'm not going to project my opinion here. I'm sorry. I almost did. So, develop cost competitiveness matrices for South Louisiana. Identified market expansion opportunities. Model efficiency. Ongoing research. LA should maximize its natural and man-made transportation infrastructure. Some of the strengths are bulk and break bulk freight markets, agriculture, coal, petroleum, chemicals, and good base of export tonnage. So the number one that's really on their list first is the petroleum. Then it's the chemicals. Then it is machinery, and then it is coal, then it is agriculture. New Orleans is closer than Houston when coming into the Gulf. So you can, in today's volatile maritime environment, an entity needs to be established to provide decision makers with the most current and accurate data to aid in the formulation of policies and programs affecting the maritime industry. Okay. Well, this is just an amazing undertaking. And so I'm going to leave the link. You can go in and you could actually take a look at the maps. what their intentions are for all of the lakes and the rivers and everything that hooks up to the Mississippi. And you can read about, you know, how much money they're projecting to make. So, as always, I just thought this was really interesting in light of what's going on down in the Gulf and in the southeastern part of Louisiana. As always, God bless.